working on taking off the this fender so I can get in and get the inner fender out and then get in there and do some welding and finish welding up the floorboards and getting it ready to do the roof on the cab. So we'll get started on that. There it is. So I had to cut this one off, and then I had to cut two of these off, but they're just these clips, so they'll be easy to fix. So that one down there, and this is the one they hide inside the cab. So yeah, there you go, there's a fender. So this inner fender wasn't as rusty as the other side, but I got one to replace it. So now I'll just, I gotta pull the battery out and we'll get that taken apart. Thank you. That's useless. See if this one's any better. So, this is the first time this truck's ever been blown apart since it was assembled at the factory. So, I'm glad I'm getting some of the parts to come loose. Okay, so get this set up so I can get you in there. All right, well, so now you can see this is the piece I cut out. You can see how rotted it is there. I'm gonna have to work that over. This piece here have to be replaced. It's not nearly as bad as the other side. So that'll be one of the next projects. But she's coming apart. What's cool about these old Fords is the hood is attached to the cab and you don't have to pull the hood off. and have it laying around to get to the fenders and stuff off. And what you're actually supposed to do is you're supposed to pull the radiator support and the grill and take it apart that way, but I wasn't going to reuse, I'm not going to reuse the inner fenders, so I just trashed them. And this one's a little different, the way it goes on there. This one bolted in, the driver's side bolts in, and the passenger side, I guess it's because of the heater, has studs. So that's kind of cool. But there we are so far.